Welcome to another Observability Lab. Today, we're focusing on yet another self-service use case. It's centered around log-driven problem detection, so making it easier to detect problems based on logs. And for this, I actually brought Adam in, who has recently built a new tutorial. Hey, Adam, how are you doing?
Hey, Andy, I'm good. How are you doing?
Good, good. So logs. We hear logs more and more these days, at least in our communities. And I want to throw a use case over to you. And just like kind of walk through what I hear, and then I want to just get a little bit of a confirmation from you, what you see, and then we jump into the tutorial that you build. The thing that I hear out there is we have application teams that are on the one side, either building their own custom code, are responsible for third-party code, or for packaged apps that they need to deploy and operate. And all of these different components will emit certain logs that are important, like what you see here, wasn't able to connect to Redis, which is one log line out of many log lines, maybe in a very heavily distributed app. And so what I want as a developer or as a team, as an application team that's responsible for it, I want to get notified if those logs are coming in. So I need to be able to pinpoint and highlight that these are important. The second thing I want, if disaster strikes, if a problem comes in, I want to enrich the notification that is sent to the team on call with additional information. Who owns this component? To which product does it belong to? Maybe also some cost sent information that might open up some additional use cases, but very importantly, support info. In this case, we can see the support info is pointing the person that gets this information to an ops runbook. So providing this is in a declarative way as part of a deployment for either custom code, third-party, or packaged apps would then end up being, in Dynatrace, a Davis detector problem that is automatically enriched with team information, with the context of the actual problem, Redis connection failed. What else do we get? In that same problem, we get information that was provided through the support info. Hey, there's a cart service issue. And if you want to know more, please contact the owner. And here's also an ops runbook. And then the last thing is, as part of the problem, we also want to get not only the one log that triggered the problem, but all the surrounding logs, and then being able to drill and dig deeper, maybe into traces, the runbook, obviously, maybe into some events. Adam, I want to pause here for a second. This is the use case that I hear. Is there anything that you want to highlight before we jump into the demo that you built?
Yeah, I think it's important to double down on that idea that, you know, sometimes we are building apps that we control and we can go back and modify the logs. But sometimes it's not that easy. Sometimes we've got COT systems or systems that, you know, are older. And that's what we'll see today in this demo. is we're not actually touching the app at all. We are taking those logs and enriching that outside of the app. So it's a much lighter way to do what you need to do, as you say, to get the information into the problem record in Dynatrace.
Yeah, I think, and that's a big point, right? You cannot, in most cases, change the code to maybe add additional context to the log when it gets created in the app itself, but you may need to do this somewhere else. So Adam, what you've built, and I will give you the chance to then demo it in a second, is a full GitHub tutorial that is basically doing what we just explained. You're using the OpenTelemetry Demo app, which is an app that we didn't modify at all. So the demo app is very, you know, you can see multi different microservices. I know it has a feature flag in there that once turned on will produce some critical errors. But essentially, by just enriching the deployment information, as we've seen earlier, and I know you showed this in the demo, as logs get collected, the OpenTelemetry collector will enrich the logs based on that metadata, will tag a log that is important, and will enrich it with the additional support information. Then all this data gets sent over to Dynatrace, where in the OpenPipeline, we're basically looking for these particular logs that are enriched with this metadata to then generate events that will then lead to a problem that shows up exactly as we said earlier, full context about who owns the problem, links to additional support information, and then the ability to drill down. Here's the link to that tutorial that you built, Adam. Also, the QR code, the link will also be in the description of this video. But now, without further ado, I want to switch over to you because I want to see this in action and showing people that everybody can do this themselves and then hopefully also implement this in your environment. So let's switch over.
Okay, thanks. So we obviously collect some information. The only thing you need for this demo is a Dynatrace SaaS tenant. And then you can see here, we just have a button on a web page that will open up the environment in a virtual cluster. So let's dig into how this all works. Andy, as you said, what we're doing, very light touch, we're taking one of those microservices, the cart service, and we are annotating the pods to add extra information that we know as a team, who owns the service, the product, the cost center, and critically, as you say, the support info. So if something goes wrong, I want to be able to use this information to provide it to my ops team or my automation software to actually action the fix. So as the logs flow through the collector, we are grabbing that metadata and pushing that onto the logs in real time, as you can see here. And then we're doing one other thing, which is creating a new log out of thin air, effectively. So as the logs come through, there is a rule here in the collector that says, if the log is from the cart service and it contained wasn't able to connect to Redis, that's important enough. I know as a developer, that's important enough that I want an alert immediately. I don't want to wait around. I want to action that immediately.
And Adam, I think the great thing about this is, as you said, you're using OpenTelemetry. The same would be possible if somebody would use, let's say, Fluent or any other log collectors to enrich it. But the nice thing is you are not able to touch the code to change the log itself, but you know certain log messages are important. So you're enriching the log messages of a third-party app as they're being transformed in the data pipeline to the backend system, which in our case is Dynatrace.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Perfect.
So in the demo, we create the issue and we tell Dynatrace that a configuration change is going to happen, and then we make that configuration change, and of course an error occurs and we get the problem ticket. So as you can see, the problem ticket has all of the relevant information that we were pulling from those logs. So I instantly know that my team is involved, and of course I can use that in downstream rules to direct alerts into Slack or Teams, for example. And I also have access to the logs. So following what Dynatrace is asking me to do and following the recommended queries, I can run this query to see why this problem occurred. And of course, we know it wasn't able to connect to Redis. In this log, I have lots and lots of information, the trace ID, the ownership information, the cost information, and I can drill straight into, for example, the trace. So I've now jumped from the log line into the trace, and of course, the button up here, I can drill back from the trace to the log. So I can go either way, and this is the full trace of what actually happened. So you can see we are checking out, we're placing an order. And if I scroll down, the error occurs when we're trying to empty the cart. And if I click into here, you can see that we have the full stack trace and the line of code that is at fault. Now, of course, I can drill from here to the service to see kind of higher level what the impact of this was. And I can notice on the trace, that I have a configuration changed event. And this configuration change event has all of the metadata around what actually changed. So now I've gone from my problem in a couple of clicks straight to what actually caused that issue. And I can now start to remediate the problem.
Yeah, super powerful. Everything is connected. Everything is in context. Adam, can you go back to that problem? Because I still want to see this runbook. This was just phenomenal for me to see.
You're right. I didn't show you that. Okay. So back on the problem, you can see that the developer as we saw from the pod annotations, actually hinted that if something goes wrong, here's how you fix it. And you can see it here. If the cart service is having issues, let's have a look at the runbook.
That's pretty powerful. So the idea is that whenever you are marking a certain log as critical, that should then create a problem. Obviously, we want to encourage a best practice of defining at least a basic runbook information, what to do, who to contact. And in Dynatrace, this could be done through a notebook, as you can see here, and you can now link that notebook to a problem. And we've done it in such an elegant way that this can be done through an annotation on your deployment, which I think is just really extremely well done. And also thanks to some of our colleagues who came up with that use case and also with the implementation. Adam, I have one more question. We mentioned OpenPipeline. Can you quickly open up the OpenPipeline for me? Because this is, I think, another piece in the Dynatrace configuration. So we are enriching the logs as they come in, either through Fluent, OpenTelemetry. It could also be obviously just ingested with the Dynatrace One agent. But what have you done in the OpenPipeline configuration as the logs end up in Dynatrace to extract that event from that critical log message?
Yeah, you're absolutely right. That's the missing piece here. So the way OpenPipeline works, you have pipelines and routing. So if you think all of the log lines are flowing into Dynatrace, we want to hand pick or select some of those to treat differently. So in this case, I'm saying any log lines that have a service name of cart service and a DT owner of team A. So I'm really being hyper specific on just the logs that I care about, then redirect those to a pipeline that I've created called Redis pipeline. Now in that pipeline, we can do lots of stuff. We can process the logs, we can extract metrics from the logs. But what I'm doing in this demo is proactively sending an alert. So when those logs come in, there's a further processing that says only the logs that have an alert me equals true create a Dynatrace problem, and again, enrich with all of this ownership and cost information.
Very cool. Yeah. And so that's the, this is how you can also enforce best practices, right? You basically give the power to the engineers to annotate the logs, to annotate their deployments. And as logs get sent to Dynatrace, those that are marked with a particular piece of metadata with certain tags will then be converted into problems. And then the problem will be enriched with things like the support info on the event description. Awesome. Adam, thank you so much for this. I want to quickly switch back to the slide. Here we go. Folks, if you want to try this out yourself, the lab is online available, and you can either use the QR code, type in the URL, or just click on the link at the bottom of this video. With this, Adam, there are probably so many more use cases we will come up with in the future. But for today, I want to say thank you so much. It was awesome to have you. And that's it.
It's great to be here.
Thank you.
Thanks, Andy.
Bye.
Bye.